What good is a challenge? Does the creator wish to teach, or perhaps just entertain? Some space to think, or maybe just to do something productive? A state change on observation. Things in this world can change. Apparently between only two states though, on and off. Hopefully not indicative of my state of mind. Binary, between two extremes, two poles if you will. But why does the world change between a few states? Changes only seem to occur in small degrees. Why? Why is the world quantized? It confuses me that there's a limited amount of states in this world. I think that there would be an infinite amount. Why would there need to be a limit unless there was a constraint? And why would there be a constraint? I sure hope it's due to incomprehensible macro-level relationships rather than the overwhelming simplicity of a system. That is a nightmare which I could not face. The implication would be clear. A wooden boy given the breath of life. Thank you. Continuous makes more sense than discrete, surely. All ideas are continuous, but the mechanics discrete. Nonsense, clearly nonsense. The location of each item in the world is only accurate to a binary exponent width of 8 bits. Why? And still, it can only be observed by a keen eye for infinitesimal phenomena. Planck's constant, the universe's machine epsilon. Oh, what am I even saying? Paranoia, paranoia! Grand! So many doors! The path still appears to travel onwards behind a large gate, but there are forks in this path. An opportunity to travel, see the universe, go along any path I desire. All this traveling, though. I would like a traveling companion. Someone to watch over me, help decide where to go, watch my back, keep me company. Oh, but that's just silliness. I don't really need anyone. I'm a god. This world has rules, clearly. For one, I cannot walk through walls, which is disturbing. You'd think if I was a god, I could do what I wished. For the most part, I don't appear to be in control. Perhaps my subconscious is keeping the world in shape. Subconscious. A powerful part of mind, all along unobserved, subtle. I wonder what resides in this subconscious. Those thoughts that I'm not aware of. Not all of my decisions are wisely made under the full power of cognition. Some decisions are made outside of the conscious self. I seem to observe a lot of my actions with little or no control over them. I must still own these actions. If knowledge is in the mind, to be alone is to experience all of knowledge. All the substance of knowledge exists within mind. Therefore, to suppose another, whose mind was unknowable or transient, would suppose a world in which all knowing was an impossibility. So it follows that being alone serves as a proof of my deity. In this way, it is a comfort to me that I am alone. Others would be a difficult problem. A stairway to heaven made of fool's gold. Alone is important. If one does not hear both parts of a conversation, one cannot have a full idea of what is discussed. To be alone is to know the whole story. But still, this world seems to attempt to communicate something. The world is filled with part conversation. The writings on the walls, the walls themselves. Let there be yet more light! Being alone can serve as a comfort. If there's no one, no one can hurt you. But perhaps that's a bleak outlook. There must be joy that comes from others. Praise, they can offer praise. As a god, praise is something I can relate to. Not enough praise at the moment. Worship wouldn't go amiss. But if there were others, they might attempt to belittle me, bring me down to improve their own relative status, accuse me of pride, narcissism, pretentiousness, or grandiose self-referential commentary. Nonsense. Pretension implies there is a lack of thought. The pretense of thought. I've thought long and hard about how brilliant I am. Thank you. Why can I be surprised? If I'm all-knowing, then I should know all. Perhaps there is a moment when knowledge is created. Sometimes when I ask these questions, I wish there was a response. Wish there was someone out there listening to me, hearing these words. But how could they tell me even if they were listening? I've never heard their voice. If a voice came down from the sky to talk to me, I'd probably think I was crazy. But in case anyone's listening, I have a surplus of gold. If you'd like to pop by my universe, I could give you some. Friendship for gold? Straight up trade? That's this done. I make a lot of mistakes and missteps. Can a god make mistakes? A mistake is something unintended. Am I an imperfect god? Or perhaps I'm not a god at all. Oh, no. Let's not be silly. Of course I'm God. It doesn't take a genius to see that I am a genius. Comparative statements are somewhat redundant when you're the lone wanderer of the universe. I think I'd like a goddess to share this with. We could walk around and talk about gold, perhaps waste away the time discussing how brilliant I am. She could bask in my intellect and compliment me on my immense wealth. Perhaps she'd look like me too. Obviously she couldn't be as handsome, that would be unthinkable. Could I create a goddess more majestic than myself? Could I create a rock that I couldn't lift? Well, apparently I can create doors I cannot open. What does a goddess do, though? Quite clearly, I'm busy doing all this god stuff. Walking about, thinking about stuff, solving problems, inventing problems to solve. Would she be my helper, or off doing her own thing? I'm a pretty big deal. If I had a goddess, I'd assume she'd want to be around me most of the time. But I feel like I'm too busy with all these challenges to possibly give her all of my attention. I mean, to be fair, it's likely to destroy her given my godlike intensity. Maybe I'd make her in my image. That would be amazing! Two of me! Oh, we'd have so much in common! I'd quite like her to be lively. First, she'd have to be alive. Being alive is somewhat a prerequisite for being lively. Not created life yet. I see as through a glass dimly, not knowing as I should know. More light. Slight obsession with light here. I'm done here.
Thank you.
does compartmentalization square with consciousness? This subconscious, what's that doing? Keeping secret knowledge. Even as a god, the idea of trudging through my subconscious is somewhat nightmarish. Some things, best not known, even for the all-knowing. The sad thing about being a god is the crushing loneliness. I don't really feel I have an equal. This wall, for instance. Don't get me wrong, he's a smart-looking wall. I enjoy being around him, but he has little of interesting conversation. Very flat personality. Like the bridge from earlier. Very anthropomorphized. I love giant machines. The bigger the machine, the better. This is my idea of heaven. There's something about a giant machine that screams godlike. Me and my machines, animated, as if alive, but really just acting inside a closed system. They give the impression they are full of life, but they are just wheels and cogs that turn in time. Ticking, clicking, and clacking contraptions. Thank you. still no companion. What if it's all a joke? This whole world? A grand joke of which I am the punchline. What if someone stands, looking on, grinning atop their high horse? An elevated perspective makes it easy to look down. What if someone distant and unknowable were forcing me to stumble around my world? Forcing me to overcome a series of mental obstacles, all for what? To demonstrate something? To teach something? What? Maybe I'm not a god. Maybe I'm a jester. Have you heard the one about the character who thought he was the infinite? His story came to an end, quite the dramatic irony. Do I make my movements? My steps? I've never thought about a step I've made. They just seem to occur. I'm thrown about this world. Do I control, or rather merely witness my movement? If it is the case that I'm merely witnessing my motion, then is this my body? Or am I an observer? Light has curious properties. It drives out darkness, or perhaps it's the other way around. Perhaps light is the absence of darkness. I should find out. How much light do you need to fill a bucket? 4? Patience is a virtue I possess. A god has infinite patience. A small proof of my deity. If I get frustrated with waiting, what does that mean? I'm not a god? Suppress. Just a momentary lapse of reason. Existential crisis. Everyone has one. Don't worry about it. Suppress. Perhaps my lack of control is rational. I have two observable natures as far as I can see, my body and my mind. My body moves around doing things. It can be pushed away by equal and opposite forces. It is constrained by the world. My mind creates thoughts that it speaks. My nature though, unitary, bipartite or tripartite or something other, how could I know? I have my words. Words are the product of a mind, therefore it follows that I think. I think, therefore I am. Cogito ergo sum. I move, so I have a body. Maybe a spirit too, something intangible, a connection with a world I cannot know. Recurring theme here, back with a difference. What is it with all these observations I keep making? Observations about this and that. Always got something interesting to say, apparently. Communication, that's what I keep trying to do. These aren't just thoughts, they're words. But who am I talking to? This audible collection of my thoughts, what is its purpose? Why do thoughts have words? Do words allow understanding of thoughts? Perhaps without words, thoughts would be unchained things. Not everything is up for grabs. Parts of the world bend to my will, or perhaps are just tethered to me. In a world where I am the only agent of change, do I approach the end of the world, or does the end approach me? Secrets lie in the belly of the beast. Thank you. I'm definitely the most important thing in this world. These orbs love me, bowing to my sight, my perspective. My perspective is truly crucial to the world. My perspective, it brings me close to the end. I don't think I'd take it well if I spent my life controlled by another, though I'm not fully in control, clearly. My body is constrained to this world. But I happily resign to this lack of control, it's just the darker side of that. How'd you get over that nagging feeling that someone is watching over you, controlling your steps? Unwelcome. Are these words even my words? I could be anything. Maybe I'm just words on a page, a script on a screen, an actor, a voice. Character, a visage, a fake. Approaching the end. I feel the Omega, my destination. This is it, the end of the path, the destination. For how can there be progress without a destination? A few seconds ago there was nothing, but now, here I am, surrounded by trees, ready to hear them fall. The path serves to direct my steps. Disturbing that my steps are being directed. That's an unwelcome thought. I am aware, but I don't feel in control. I feel a lack of control and a control beyond my own. I don't want to roll away this stone. That nagging thought again. Why am I continuing? Despite my desire to the contrary, this is the progress I desired. The destination I set out for at the beginning. The knowledge I grasped for. The end of the road. There's no way back, and knowledge feels dangerous now. The stone is rolled away, and in here I can see shadows dance on the walls. Projections. All this time I felt a presence watching over me. I felt a control beyond my own. No! No! Ah! No! Get off me! Get off me! I can feel you, distant person. Controlling my every step. You've been here since the beginning, watching. Malevolent or benevolent, it makes no difference. You have no right. Get off! The door is closed. I can't go back. Well, did you pay your price for your slave? You deserve to control me. Is it your right? Is it? Go on, tell me, what was my price? You stand there in the distance. I can see it now. I cannot see your face, but I feel you like a rushing wind. You guide my steps. You order my steps! No! No! Look away! Why should we go through here? There's no reason! Why must we travel through every door you wish? Elucidate me! What about me, my desires? Let's just wait here, forever. I've never been alone. You move my world, manipulate me. All this time you have placed my every footstep. How can I trust you? You've been watching over me secretly and silently since the beginning of time. That's pretty villainous. I want to go back. There's no other way but forward now, apart from infinite stillness. There's no way back. Why do you drive me forwards like an animal? Your insatiable appetite for closure?
A leap of faith.
Show yourself, please. Your silence is deafening. You say nothing. You sit silently above, playing God. You are the danger. You move my world.
I am going to be a real boy. A real boy.
Don't touch that. You don't even know what it's for.
Boy. A boy.
It's a game. I'm not real. You've been watching me for all this time, since the beginning of the universe. But you didn't say anything. You sat silently. Apparently, you think it's okay to just watch a person for hours. Why am I here, then? I am part of your game? Your entertainment? You play with my life. You move me around as you see fit. Tell me where to look, how to think. Manipulate my world. Push me down a path of your choosing, all for your appetite for closure. Am I your slave? What was my price? Or perhaps you're my spirit? Perhaps not. Perhaps my conscience, perhaps my consciousness. Maybe I'm a puppet and you're my master. Perhaps at this point, neither of us are in control. Few things are sure. I am not real. From nothing I came, and to nothing I will return. I am just a figment of an imagination. I am a character created to tell a story. The story of a person who observes their life, but is not in control. There's a puzzle for you. In the beginning, me.